Hi there. My name is Kimberly Ray at kimberlyray.com, and today I want to show you from beginning to end how you can self-publish your book on Amazon's KDP self-publishing option for less than $20 total. So if you're a new author, you're looking at self-publishing, you're kind of like, what do I do? Where do I even start? You are in the right place. I am recording this on Zoom so that I can screen share. So I am looking totally blurry, but the screen's going to look awesome, and you don't care what I look like anyway. So that's good. Again, my name is Kimberly Ray. I am what's known as a hybrid author. So I've had some books traditionally published and some books self-published. I've got about 35 right now. And self-publishing has completely changed over the past 20 years. And I want to tell you a little bit about that because the reason it's changed is the reason we're able to do this right now. And it's kind of good to appreciate it and understand it. So if you don't care about the history about it at all or the backstory and you just want to get to show me how to do this, then just skip about what 5 minutes. So self-publishing has been around pretty much since the printing press, you know, people paying someone to print what they had to say. But as far as, you know, in the American market, there were the traditional publishers, and they were the ones who pretty much decided these books are worth going on the market, and they made high quality material. And then if you couldn't get into the traditional market, then maybe you had to pay someone to print your book yourself. And so often there was a stigma with self-publishing that was basically kind of like, well, if you self-published, it meant you weren't good enough to be accepted by the traditional publishers. And that has completely changed within my lifetime. I've kind of watched it happen. It's been pretty cool, actually, because of two things, I think, really. One would be the creation of the ebook and digital options. And the second one would be Amazon itself and their self-publishing option. So when the ebook started, that changed everything. Suddenly, the whole world was kind of open to everybody instead of just this one aspect of publishing that had the power and kind of a monopoly, and not in a bad way. It's just the way the system worked. But when ebooks came out, suddenly people had the power to put their own books out there on their own. And the bad side of that was that, you know, there were a lot of bad books getting put out there, poorly edited with typos, you know, or the cover looked like somebody's high school Photoshop experience. But on the good side, it meant that people were able to get their books out there that wouldn't have been normally published. You know, maybe they had this tiny little topic that most people weren't interested in, but they were able to get it out to the people who were. Or maybe it was this, you know, brand new thing that it was kind of a risk and most publishers wouldn't have taken it. Then it turns into this big, huge bestseller. And so that was kind of cool watching that, the change and the shift and kind of the power system. But then still, even when ebooks came out and things changed and self-publishing became less of a, oh, your book's not good enough, and more of a, oh, you're like an indie author kind of thing and kind of cool, then Amazon created KDP, and that made it an option to make paperbacks as well for people who wanted to self-publish. Because prior to that, there are self-publishing, they call them vanity presses, or there are a lot of those companies that are like, we'll take your book and we'll publish it. And, you know, we're going to get it out to all these people supposedly. And you've got to pay, you know, $3,000 and order 500 books. And now you have 500 books, you know, in your basement growing mold, and you're never going to make that money back. So why would you write another book? And so it was just kind of this big mess. It's again, still very, very risky for an author because you have to invest so much in getting your book out there. And what if it's a total dud? Or what if, like, 500 books down the road, you find a typo on page 27? What are you going to do about that? So when Amazon came out with the KDP option, it was fantastic because it put the power into the author's hands, and you can get on there, you can make your book, you can format it, or you can pay somebody to format it. You can make your own cover, or you can pay somebody to make your own cover, but you can get your book up there, and it's still totally yours. Like, all of the content is yours, all of the design is yours, all of the power basically is yours. And that's really neat. I've discovered over time that with traditional publishing, as great as it is, for one, the royalty aspect is lower. So if you're going into a traditional publishing contract, you might get like 10 or 11% of the sales, unless you're, you know, super famous and James Patterson. But through KDP, you get a much higher percentage of the royalties. And to me, what's really, really valuable about self-publishing through Amazon is, maybe I'm just a control freak, but I love having the book remain mine. So if I want to, like, for example, Stolen Woman back there, it was right at the beginning when human trafficking was becoming a big, huge topic. And I wrote a fiction novel, Christian suspense, on fighting human trafficking internationally. But then over months, I started getting some feedback from people, and they mentioned this one aspect that was kind of missing. And I realized, you know, they're right. And so I wrote four more chapters to fill that part in, and I was able to make a new edition of the book on my own. Whereas if you go through traditional publishing or a self-publishing press, you don't have the power to be like, hey, can we change this? You know, can we add four more chapters? They're kind of like, no. So the other thing is that I can make my own covers. I love designing covers. I think that's really fun. And to me, the way the book looks is just as important as what's inside of it. They say you can't judge a book by a cover, but everybody does. So I don't like handing that over to someone else and their vision of what they perceive. They don't know my book like I know my book. So I love being able to put out my own idea of what this book should look like. And if I want to change it, I can, which I often do. So there's that option as well. And I love the freedom of being in charge of my own material. And then later, if I want to pull it, if I want to change it, if I want to adapt it, that's my freedom to do, which is cool. I love that. So having said all that, you have probably written a book, or you are writing a book, and you're thinking, what do I do once it's there? It's overwhelming and it's a big learning curve. I'll just tell you that, but it's not impossible. And the nice thing is once you get used to it, it's not really that big of a deal after all that. Okay, so I'm going to share my screen. So basically, you've got this manuscript. Now, one thing that's important when you're getting started is always keep a clean text-only manuscript, because the file for a paperback and the file for an ebook is different formatting. So you always want your base just text file, because say you wanted to make a change down the road. But if you only have this file, it's going to mess it up. But if you only have this file, you know, it's kind of messy. So always keep your manuscript. That's a good thing in a basic Word document. It's not like super heavily formatted. So you got your manuscript. Say you got like 200 pages of the most amazing historical, who knows what story about Napoleon, and you want to publish it, and you've heard about Amazon. Where do you start? So I'm going to share my screen with you, and here we go. All right. So say you're on the internet, and the first thing, just look up Kindle Direct Publishing. If you do that, a bunch of stuff's going to come. See, the first thing is a sponsored thing for, you know, some publishing company that you can pay them a bunch of money and they'll do it. Scroll down. You don't want that. This is the Kindle store, so keep going. Okay, what you want is Amazon Kindle Direct Publishing Self-Publishing. There it is. Boom. So you're going to click this, and it's going to show this cute little guy on a computer. Over here to the right, it's going to say sign in. Or if you're not Kimberly, which you're not, so you want to sign in as a different user. So you're going to basically create your own account. Don't have an Amazon account? Sign up. Now, to do Amazon KDP Publishing, you do need some kind of an Amazon, actually, like customer account. So if you don't have one of those, just go sign up. No big deal. You're going to have your username, which is your email. You're going to have a password. So we'll just sign in on one of mine. And then you'll end up with this when you sign in the future. And that will get you into this beautiful little place. I spend a lot of time here. This is your dashboard for Kindle Direct Publishing. This is where you're going to start to do everything. Now, the bookshelf, that's this main page right here. And when you look down, you're going to see all the books you've made. You're going to see nothing because you haven't made me yet. But think of that as exciting, because there's lots of possibilities. Over here are reports about, you know, what's sold and what hasn't sold and, you know, all that kind of stuff. But you don't need to deal with any of that right now. Also, marketing, you don't need to deal with any of that right now. So all we're going to be looking at is this right here called the bookshelf, so that you can create a new book. So as you can see right here, create, manage, publish, create a new title or a series. Skip all of any of this. What you want right here is this big fat create button. And then it is really user-friendly. It's more than it used to be. It used to be two separate entities, and long story, but they're getting much better. So we're going to start with a paperback. When you make an ebook, that's different formatting and different aspects to it. Let's just start here, because this will be easier. Okay, so you want to create a paperback. And then you're going to see this. It's like, don't worry. You'll get familiar with it. It's not a big deal. So choose your paperback's primary language. Well, hopefully that's English. If not, you should probably be listening to somebody else. So your book title. Now, as it mentions, once your book is published, you can't change this. So decide on your title for sure before it's final. So say I'm going to do suspect. Someone. That sounds cool. Okay, so you got your book title and you got your subtitle. You don't have to have a subtitle. Now, if it's part of a series, you're going to click on here and sure, let's make a series. So new series, let's create a new series. And this will be the main content of the new series. And related content means like if it's some accessory to it. Next step. So you're going to set up a series. My series title is going to be the rescue series. Okay. Ordered, etc. Now, the cool thing about this is it does show up on Amazon. It's really cool. When you look up a book in your series, it shows like all the little ones in your series in this nice little bit. And then this is for the description. Really cool books. Now you notice it allows you 3,982 characters. That's a lot of room for you to go on and on and on. And more words is not necessarily better, but less words is not necessarily better either. So I'm just going to give you an example. Again, this is a little bit down the road if you are creating a book, but just so you understand what we're working with here, I'll show you in a moment. All right, let's see. We'll do strip. All right, so here is my book that shows up. But here's the series. And that's really cool. And it shows you all the books in the series. Let's see. So say if I look up one of these, here's my book. Now this is your Amazon page. So once your book gets published, this is what it's going to look like on Amazon, which is really, actually really neat. When you see your book on Amazon for the first time, it's like, oh, I made it. Okay. So here's your title. Sometimes the subtitle is before it. There's the Kindle edition and the paperback edition if you make an ebook as well. And then your description goes here. And you notice there's a little bit of description. So that first line or first two lines in your description are the most important. That's your hook. And you can watch a bunch of videos on that, hooks and descriptions and making it really exciting, making sure you got the right target audience and all that kind of stuff. So here's your description for it. You can read a sample over here. It'll show you the interior over here. That's what Amazon does all that. You don't have to do all that. Yay! All right, and then you come down here and it's neat. It's like, ooh, look, there's my whole series. So Amazon likes to sell stuff. And so the nice thing is that helps you because it's working with what you have and trying to make it more optimal. I guess you could say there's all kinds of algorithms and stuff. This is a neat thing that they just started doing, but it's another learning curve that I'm getting overwhelmed about from the author and, you know, like, product details and all this super interesting stuff. And there's you, and then you keep going and there's the reviews and all that kind of stuff. So that's what life's going to be like once it's up. So, you know, this is to KDP. This is where you're creating it. Okay. So back down here, edition number, don't worry about that. Author, that's you. So first name, Kimberly Ray. All right. There is room for contributors. So if you've got an illustrator or if you've got a co-author or anything like that, that's where they go. Don't put anything there. If there isn't anything, it's not a problem to leave things empty. If there is something that's required, it'll let you know. Okay, so here's your description. Again, 4,000 characters you're allowed. So you want to tell them everything they need to know to want to buy this book, but you don't want to tell them everything. You know, think of it like a movie trailer. That's what you want. So the suspect. Fights international human trafficking. Who would want to accuse her? No, set her up. Set her up. There's another word for that, but I can't think of it. I'll fix that later. So you give your description. If you have endorsements and that kind of thing, you're going to be putting things there. There's an option of this is bold, italics, underlined. You can format it if you're savvy in that direction. So there's all kinds of options of things to do. Go down here, publishing rights. I own the copyright. So if this is your book and you own it, push that. You don't want to do that. The public domain work means it belongs to the whole entire world. So it's something somebody wrote in the 1400s and for some reason you're publishing. If you push public domain, that means everybody gets it and everybody can do whatever they want to with it. So if it's yours, you do that. You want a copyright. Okay, primary audience. Adult only content. So they're making sure that you're not putting out some book that's inappropriate for children. So mine is not inappropriate. Now you might be thinking, okay, this is like not a book for kids. That's not what we're talking about. They're asking, is there like explicit stuff in here that, you know, they should not let children look at? Okay. If it's a children's book, you got reading age down here and you put your minimum age and your maximum age. So if it's a middle school, middle grade book, you can target it to your correct audience, which is cool. All right. Majority of your book sales, that's Amazon.com. Now, if you're going for Amazon Australia, Amazon the UK, Amazon in France, you can market your book to a lot of places. Let's just start here. Go for the simple and start simple, and then you can spread out later. Okay. Now, this is where it gets really fun. Choose your categories. You get to have three categories for your book. And your categories are extremely important when it comes to Amazon ranking. And I'm sorry, because this doesn't have anything to do with actually like publishing your book, but it's super important. So I'm just going to explain it. When you pick a category, Amazon is always looking for the top 100 in every category. It updates about every hour, I think. So out of the 5 million plus books that they have on Amazon, you want to get your book noticed. But if you just put it in romance, well, there's probably 3 million romance novels. And so your book is probably going to be number 2,987,000, you know, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So it's not going to put you up in the rankings. The higher you are in the rankings, the more often Amazon wants to show it to people because, again, they want to sell books. So what you want to do is find some way for you to be in a top 100 in a category. So say, for example, your book is a romance, but it happens to have this topic, there's an autistic child in it. So maybe one of your categories is going to be something like, you know, social justice or something like that. Like for me with my human trafficking books, I would go more in the direction of, justice, that sort of thing. So for this one, my thus bus suspect, we're going to make a romantic suspense, fighting human trafficking, Christian. That's important. All right, let's see. And you also want to find the correct audience because if you get the wrong audience, you're going to get bad reviews and you don't want bad reviews. So for me, for example, because I am a follower of Jesus and I write clean content that is Christian, I don't want to market it to people who are going to put reviews on of like, I can't believe she's a Christian. That's so stupid. So I want to make sure that Christian is in there so that they understand that's what this book is. You got all these categories. Now, it doesn't seem like much at first. Christian books and Bibles. Let's start there. So it's not a Bible, obviously. La la la. So I'm going to look through here. I'm going to try and find stuff, et cetera, et cetera. Mystery and suspense. So I've got Christian literature, fiction, mystery and suspense. Good job. Okay. So that's one of my categories. Add another category. So say you've written something on health and fitness and you want, you know, teen health, sports safety, whatever. There's a ton of options and it's hard to find this exact teeny weeny weeny thing, but Amazon will give you more categories based on these categories and it's complicated. But basically you want to find the one that's so exactly what you're doing that Amazon can say, oh, you belong in this little spot right here. And look at that, you know, you're number 5,000 instead of 5 million, which is great. Another just tiny little tip, the day that you put your book out, if you care about Amazon rankings and all that kind of stuff, try to get everybody to buy it on the same day because with Amazon updating every hour, they're trying to figure out who's buying the most books and they base their numbers on that. And so like if you get a whole bunch of people to buy your book in that hour in a really good category, you might be able to get in the top 100, which makes you an Amazon best-selling author just like that. Neat. Okay. So we're going to save these categories. That's good. It didn't say the health one because a Christian fiction mystery suspense health book for teens, it sounds a little weird. All right. Now, did your book classify as low content or large print? Low content means just like empty journal kind of thing. So if you actually wrote a book, then no, skip those. Okay. Now you're on to your seven keywords to describe it. These are very important. This is how people are going to find your books. So you want to put down the most specific thing that you can. So, for example, for this book, I'm going to say Christian romantic suspense. So, if somebody's looking up Christian romantic suspense, mine is one of those options. Say, I'm going to say fighting human trafficking because that's something people might be like, ooh, I want a book on fighting human trafficking. I want fiction on women knowing their worth or something like that. Or say it's set in North Carolina. Let's see, books in North Carolina or just North Carolina or something like that. That if somebody clicks on it, there's this interesting thing and it has to do with you. So you want this also kind of your genre, if you know about genres, study it if you don't. But kind of like, is it a memoir? Is it a children's book? Is it a children's book about what to do when your pet dies? Is it a self-help book? Is it a health book? Is it et cetera, et cetera? This is where you get to be a little more detailed and specific than the big category. So whatever your book is, like if somebody says, what's your book? And you tell them, it's a memoir about my grandma who lived in the Appalachian Mountains. Great. Write that down. Memoir, Appalachian Mountains, history. Sweet Southern homemade iced tea, something like that. All right. Then you're going to save it. Yay! And you can save it as a draft. So don't worry about all of this having to be perfect. You can go back and change it whenever you need to. Okay. Now we're up to the ISBN. And you can use your own ISBN. So if you buy your own, which they're expensive, and I don't know why you would. A free ISBN. Some people get concerned. Well, if I get it from Amazon, is that a problem? And I've been doing this for 15 years now, I think, and I've never had any trouble with that at all. So I have no problem pushing this. So you get yourself free ISBN. That's like the barcode thing at the bottom. It's how the world finds your book to buy it. So now I have an ISBN. Yay! This is going to need to go on inside your book somewhere and on the back cover of your book probably. It's a legal thing, but Amazon will put the barcode on, so you don't need to worry too much about that. In the inside, when you do your copyright page, that's where that goes. All right, date when your book is first published. That's if you care about a specific publication date. So, like if you're going to do a big book launch in October, you set it for October, and then you can get all this stuff ready and prepped and all that kind of stuff before you actually publish it. If you're just publishing it and you'll tell people later, don't worry about that. Leave it empty. Now we're going into the meat and potatoes of the book. But I gotta go for now, so I'm gonna stop this and start it again later. I can figure out how to do that.